What's the biz, everyone? It's your boy Baker Maker, bringing you a video, just showing you some stuff about my newest cosplay, which is Spider-Gwen. Basically, what if Harley Quinn gets bitten by a radioactive bug, and basically has the same Spidey powers as Peter Parker. So, yeah, this is like the newest cosplay I just finished. Took me a while to finish it, been working on it for months. Glad that it's finally completed. But yeah, this is basically the suit right here. So, hopefully y'all saw the pictures I took on this, on my page of me wearing it. I'm just giving you a little bit of a closer look at the costume itself and telling you a little bit of how it was done, how I made it. And yes, I did make it myself. Okay, so basically this shirt right here. Right here, yeah. Sorry about everything, my room's a little messy, but what else is new? A lot of these videos that I take, whenever y'all see my room's usually messy, but yeah. I do need to straighten up a bit, a little bit though. But anyways, yeah, this is the suit. I basically, and all you see all this pup paint, I actually did that myself. Yes, all the Spidey suits you guys probably see me wear, if they're pup painted, I did it myself completely, except for the mask. Usually the suit, like the mask, whenever I purchase the mask, the guy who makes them usually add the puff paint themselves. However, for this particular cosplay, I requested not to have any puff paint on the mask, but we'll get to that later. So, yeah, this is a suit. I puff painted myself. This is basically what I used right here. I used a blue tulip silk slick puff paint. Just a puff paint, the blue webbing I use this for, basically. Now, as you can see right here, which, you know, I used basically the same thing, well, except instead of blue, I used white as the outline right here for the white line outline. Thought it'd be cool to outline it white. And as for the inner puff paint, now this one I used, this is a little different. Instead of using the typical silk slick puff paint, I used the basically the same brand, but I used a little bit of glitter puff paint this time. I used it used both red and blue for this one. Yeah. So yeah. Basically, oh, the shirt itself, the shirt I just bought on eBay, I forgot for how much, bought it on eBay, and basically just decided to puff paint the entire shirt myself, added the blue webbing, thought it'd be cool to have blue webbing, and basically, right here, as you see, those of you who, know, like, whenever, classic Harley, her, when the outfit for classic Harley, she would usually have like red diamonds on this side and then black diamonds on the other side. But for this particular cosplay, since I'm keeping a more red and blue themed, I thought it'd be cool to have this one be red and then have the other side be blue. And basically the same thing like I did. I used white puff paint and then some glitter in the inside of it. And basically did the same thing here, except you notice like for this side I tried to I added the diamonds on the lower end, while like at the lower end of the arm of the shoulder, and same thing I used right here for yeah, basically that's it. And basically what I did in the front, I basically did the same thing in the back. Yeah. Basically did the same thing in the back too. you go. And basically used red and blue glitter. Have it half red and half blue. Thought it'd be cool. So there you go. Now, for this one, I thought it, because like this is supposed to be like a mix of Harley and Spider-Man. So, like I said, I chose to have the, like a Spidey suit, but have it, the puff paint, the webbing in blue, and some of it white. And basically I did the same thing for the gloves right here, except this time, one side red and the other side blue. I actually used some leather paint for this one. Basically I used this for the red. Let me see, where's the blue? Here's the blue right here. For the blue, this is what I used. Yeah. Now, that's basically the shirt. Now, here's the pants. Basically, I did most of the puff paint here is done in white. Then some of the puff paint in blue, added blue diamonds, and basically did the same thing with this side being red diamonds. And basically did the same thing for the back. But yeah. Now, time to show you as for the shoes. And those of you wondering what the shoes look like, basically these are the shoes right here. For this to make this happen, basically what I did was I bought some water shoes on eBay, and this is basically what I do for all my Spidey cosplays. I buy water shoes, cut the like the top part of it off, either with a knife or with some scissors, and I bought some boot covers on eBay as well. These are boot covers, and basically used shoe glue, and used some shoe glue to glue the boot covers onto these. Yeah, and basically shoe glued them together. Oops, looks like I'm going to have to shoe glue a little bit more, apparently. But yeah, basically, yes, I even puff painted the boot covers as well. All blue. Now, I also bought me a red and blue hat. I actually bought this a while ago at Hot Topic. No, Spencer's. I bought these at Spencer's. Yeah, I thought it'd be perfect for this cosplay. And basically I use, you know, same collar and the same stuff I use for my classic Harley outfit and stuff that I put around my wrist. Now as for the mask, now the most important thing was the mask. Basically I have this guy, the same guy who makes all my other Spidey masks. I requested him to make an all white mask. And what he did, and decided not to add any puff paint to it, no webbing. And as for this, the red and blue lenses right here, I did that myself. I painted it, used blue leather paint and used red leather paint for these. And the reason why I chose them for the mask to be white to represent, because you know how like when my Harley Quinn, I usually have like clown makeup on, so that's supposed to be what it be. What the mask is supposed to represent, but that's it. Just wanted to show you guys everything, the rundown. I'll do a part 2 with me wearing the costume. So until then, stay beast.